Today, I'm presenting this free chapter. Actually, it's not a one meeting agenda. We can continue it for three, four meetings as well. I have not yet incorporated the exercises part. For the first two chapters, that is models basics and building models, I have taken a different approach, econometrics approach, rather than machine learning that is advocated in this book. I will justify what's the difference and why I have taken this and what we need to do if we want to incorporate machine learning also. In the third chapter, many models, I have taken a how-to approach. In these first two chapters, I am explaining what to do and what is the backbone, how under the hood the LM function works. And thereafter, when it comes to many models, it's a complicated chapter. Even when Arnab was presenting the iteration chapter, the map functions were complicated as such. And here also, we will use map, but in different contexts. And that will be complicated there too. That's why I have taken how to approach that, how we can implement it. There are some more books also, not just R4DS, because R4DS deals only with the basics of the LM. There are other books which are written specifically for linear models. For example, first one is An R Companion to Applied Regression by John Fox. It accompanies the CAR package. CAR stands for Companion to Applied Regression. Then there is Linear Models with R by Julian Faraway. If you remember, Faraway is the author of the 72-page handout, which you can download from CRAN website also. It introduces linear model and ANOVA. Here, this Faraway has also written one more book, Extending Linear Models. And same Faraway package contains the data sets and functions required for these two books. And then there is one more interesting book, Applied Predictive Modeling by Max Kuhn. It accompanies the CURRET package. This book not only deals with linear model, but other machine learning algorithms as well. For example, K-nearest neighbor is also there. CURRET package actually provides a unified interface for all these machine learning algorithms, be it classification or regression or whatever. The problem was that this CURRET packet does not incorporate the tidy or pipe friendly workflow. So this developer Max Kuhn has now joined R Studio and he is now developing tidy models packages. What does a model do in your analysis or in your research? You can either use this model for understanding the phenomena, that is, you infer how something works. And then there is another purpose, is to predict the future value. That is a prediction. Econometrics and machine learning differ in these two aspects. Econometrics uses the model for the purpose of understanding the phenomena, that is inference only. But machine learning tries to predict the future value. I will come back to this point later also. A natural question is, before you fit your model, should you skip or should you conduct your exploratory data analysis? I would say no, because the model quality is dependent highly upon your exploratory data analysis. The quality of your model is as good as your exploratory data analysis. The models have assumption. For example, if you apply linear regression, then also there are some assumption. Your data should be normally distributed at some point, whatever the assumption be, but assumption will be there. You will have to check your data. Does your data actually fulfill those assumptions? If not, you cannot apply this model. So you should never skip this. You will also lose your insight. In fact, there are only two ways to decide which model to apply. First one is your exploratory data analysis, and then second is literature review. But the problem is the literature review you are outsourcing your exploratory data analysis to someone else. You are trusting that someone else does your exploratory data analysis, and on the basis of that, you are applying your model. And sometimes that may also be difficult. I would give an example. One hospital is treating corona patient, and say, for example, Leelavati Hospital in Mumbai. They observe that some medicine is effective for this patient, and therefore they publish this finding to other doctors. But can Tata Memorial Hospital in Mumbai use this finding? They can see that Leelavati Hospital has done their data analysis, but will the same medicine cure the corona patient in Tata Memorial Hospital also? Questionable. Because Tata Memorial deals with cancer patients. So the Tata Memorial Hospital patient will have cancer plus corona. Will the same medicine be as effective as Leelavati Hospital patient? Maybe or may not be. That's why in your case also, it may happen that the data collected by someone else had some different purpose, and therefore the model adopted by them may not be applicable to your data set probably. And that's why even if someone else has done your literature review or exploratory data analysis, you should also do it, so that your model remains valid for your data at least. And what do you do in exploratory data analysis? The first thing to do is univariate numeric analysis. That as simple as like a str function. You can see what kind of data set it is. Or I would find summary function more useful, because I know how the data is encoded in it. Sometimes, for example, in empty car dataset, cylinder, CYL variable, it is encoded as numeric. But when I see in depth, I know that it's a factor variable. There are three levels, 4, 6, and 8. Summary function tells me this. At least I can see what problem it is. Then there is univariate visual. You plot the variables, just one variable. You can even prepare histogram or something like that. I find Brinton package more useful in this case. Let me share that also right now. This Brinton package has three functions, wide plot, long plot, and plot up. The first wide plot explores visually entire data set. For example, if you say wide plot into bracket empty cars, then it will create a grid of graphics. One row of graph will be dedicated to one variable in empty cars. So you can see which graph is interesting for you, and then you can decide which variable you want to plot further. Then there is long plot function. But in long plot, there are two arguments, name of the data set and name of the variable. So now you are plotting only one variable. For example, it is cylinder, then it will create graphics only for cylinder in empty cars dataset. And then plot up function. There are three arguments in this case. When you conduct this long plot, all the graphics will be named. For example, violin plot, box plot, whatever. So in plot up function now, you not only specify the data set variable, but also the name of the graph, violin plot or whatever the plot you want to see. By default, the output will be HTML, and I just change it to console. Because if I specify it as console, it will also give me ggplot code along with the graph. So I can put it in my research finding also. Then bivariate numeric, I think declare is best for this. Group by plus summary, that's what I'll do. In Bazaar also, there is aggregate function which does the same thing. And then bivariate visual for this function, for this purpose, I find ggle make it more useful. ggle has one function that is ggpairs. ggpairs not only prepares a scatter plot matrix, but also gives us the covariation matrix as well. Correlation matrix, sorry. So we know which variables are highly correlated with one another, and which variable we can skip in your further analysis process. And then when we actually apply this linear model, how we allocate the data? Machine learning and econometrics differ in this aspect as well. You can either use the observation, say for example, in empty cars, there are 29 observations. So will you use all the 29 observations or 29 rows for generating your hypothesis, for creation of your model? Econometrics says yes. You should use all these observations to generate the linear model. But machine learning says no. You should only use some of the observation for generating hypothesis or generating model, and use the rest of the observation for validating your hypothesis or confirming it. Each observation can be used only for one purpose. Either you use it for generating hypothesis, or you use it to confirm the hypothesis. Nowadays, the practice is that you use 60% of the observation for hypothesis generation. On this 60%, you apply different models. For example, first time you apply linear model, then generalized linear model, then k-nearest neighbor model, and then generalized additive model. All kinds of model you can use, and decide which one is the best, which one explains this 60% data well. Then you decide this model is the best, and you should check it on the 20% data so that your model is validated. And now you fine tune the model, and the rest of the last 20% of the data will be used for cross validation. That is further testing. So that's where econometrics and machine learning differ. For example, yes, the issue with the econometrics is that they want just to understand the phenomena. They just want to infer how something happens. But in machine learning, the important matter is prediction. You should be able to predict the future value of the outcome variables. In econometrics, the researcher wants to use all the available observations to generate the model. But in machine learning, some of the observation will be reserved or would be spared for testing and cross validation. And that's why the overfitting phenomenon, which means your model explains the existing data very well. Overfitting happens more in econometrics, because we have use all the data only to generate the hypothesis, generate the linear model, or whatever the model it be. And now you know what, how this phenomenon occurs with respect to the data you have. But when at a later stage new data arise and you try to fit that same model on new data, the explainability is poor. This is called overfitting. But in machine learning, it rarely happens because you have already used many data. And in fact, if you have used methods like 10-fold cross-validation or like that resampling method, then you would have used all kinds of models. You know which model does best. So overfitting, the probability of overfitting is less in machine learning methods. And how does econometric work? In fact, similarly, you can also use machine learning workflow also. The first step is to explore the data and to come up with possible model, which model can be applied in this data. Then you check whether your data set fulfills the assumption which are required for your model. Say, for example, in linear model, there are a few assumptions. If you want to apply linear model, you check with your data. Are these variables normally distributed? Are the assumptions fulfilled for the linear model? Only then you can apply linear model to your data set at hand. Then you apply the model and then diagnose the model. There are packages for this also. In fact, it can be done with Bayes' R also, but as we are following tidyverse approach, I would recommend some more packages like Lindia, LINDIA. It's a short form of linear diagnosis. If you have tried using linear model in Bayes' R, there is simple plot method. Plot, then model name. It will generate a matrix or grid of plot of four: residual versus fitted, then Poop-Distance graph, etc. If you try to do it in ggplot, it will take a long time or many tweaking, and that's why I am recommending this this package, because it does it in one step. Then if there is a problem in this model, then you transform the data and repeat the same process, because you have to explain the phenomenon. And if needed, you will have to change. If you come to conclusion that this particular model is not explaining this phenomenon well, you will have to change the another model. Which model can we apply? Maybe linear regression model, which we will deal with more in these two chapters. Then generalized linear model. Then there is penalized linear model also, which is deal with GLM net package. LM and GLM both are in stats package, which is distributed with Bayes' R. So we don't need any more package for that. But for penalized linear model, we will need GLM net. Then generalized additive model. They are built with in MGCV package, and the particular function is GAM. There are particular situations when this kind of model will be used. For example, in this situation, your dependent variable or the explain variable, not the predictor, the explain variable will have a polynomial type of curve. In that case, you will use GAM rather than your linear model, LM or GLM. Then there is robust linear model. That is also this mass package is also distributed with Bayes' R. Actually, mass is also before R, there was S, programming language for statistics. So mass is a short form of the book written with S statistical package, and with that package came the robust linear model, which is continued in R also. Then there are trees. R part is the package dealing with the tree models. Decision tree kind of model or classification kind of models. Now we will come to linear regression model LM. We use LM function for applying linear regression. The output of this function is LM. If you type the function class into bracket model name, then it will show LM class. It's a list, not a tidy data set, not a rectangular data set, or a, you will say, not a table. But if you want to know more about the model, you will have to run summary function. Because the if you type just the model name, then it will show a gibberish kind of output. But the summary of that model will show meaningful information for you. I would go deep into the formula notation, which is Wilkinson-Rother formula notation, as they are calling. They use tilde operator. On the left-hand side, the explained variable or the dependent variable. For example, when you use LM into bracket MPG tilde dot, then MPG is your explained variable or dependent variable, and dot in this context means all the other variables, all the other columns in the data set of empty cars. The variables on the right hand side of the tilde are, it may be one variable or multiple variables. They will be called predictor variables or independent variables. And this LM function will have two main arguments. The one is the formula, which contains tilde, and the name of the data set. And the data set must be loaded in the global environment. You cannot directly write the LM function. You will have to load the data set first using the data function. And then only you will be able to use it. Particularly if your data set comes from another package, you will have to use it. If you are trying it with empty cars only, then not an issue, because it will be anywhere loaded automatically when you load R and RStudio. For example, this is your equation where MPG is explained variable and cylinder is predictor and data equal to empty cars. So this is the function to specify one particular model. We are trying to understand MPG as a function of this cylinder. You can read it MPG as explained by this plus this plus this, whatever. If there are multiple variables, they will be separated by plus sign. What does it actually mean? If you remember Cartesian geometry, there is a function for linear line. Y equal to mx plus c, where m is slope and c is a constant or the intercept of that line, and xy is a point on that line. Same thing is done by linear model function, LM function. MPG, when we write it, it actually translated into MPG as a function of beta 0, that is intercept, plus beta 1 multiplied by cylinder. Beta 1 is a coefficient of cylinder. If you want to remove the intercept term, that is beta 0, you will have to specify it differently. MPG is explained by cylinder minus 1. The rest of the argument will remain the same. And which form of variables are acceptable in LM function? We can use both continuous and categorical. And not only raw form of data, but also we can transform the variables. for example, instead of MPG, we can also use log of MPG. Instead of cylinder also, we can use inverse of transpose of this, sorry, inverse. Or if you want to use polynomial variables, for example, cylinder raised to square, cylinder raised to 3 or cylinder raised to 4, then you will have to protect it using I's identity function. When you want to use squared or any polynomial variable, you have to protect it like this. Otherwise, it will understand it as interaction, not the variable. Cylinder interacting with itself. And what is the output? When you run this LM function, what will it display on your console, or what will it give it in your R Markdown document? It will be a class LM. It's a long list. But there is summary LM, which we can get through summary into bracket your model. And even the summary is not tidy data, not even a data frame, it's a list. So if you want to plot it, plot something from this, it's not possible. Therefore, we take the help of package broom. In R4DS book, they have taken help of modeler package also. It's also part of tidyverse set of packages. But I find broom more informative and more helpful compared to modeler. Broom package converts all this data into a tidy table format. And there are three main functions: tidy function, augment function, and glance. Out of this, tidy function constructs a table that summarizes the model's statistical finding. For example, if you want the coefficient of different variables, then you will use tidy function. Augment function adds column to the original data that was modeled. And these additional columns include prediction, residual, cluster assignment, etc. So this augment function can be used for creating residual versus fitted plot, the diagnosis plot, which we can use in Bayesian using the same plot method. And if you want to determine how good your model is, how well your model explains this data, for that there is glance function. It will give you one row summary of this model, includes R square, adjusted R square, AIC, BIC, log lake, etc. And if there are multiple models, then you will have to use cbind this, or otherwise there is another function, another package called performance. They have function. This function combines all the row of all the columns of this glance function. R square adjusted. They can create this function. Prepares a table that contains all the diagnostic summary. What is the R square for each model? Adjusted R square for each model. It's already prepared in a tabulated format, rectangular data. It will be a data frame only. And then there are interaction effect also. Interaction happen when one independent variable depends on another variable also. For example, if there is a weight data set, there may be, say for example, your explained variable is wages received by a person, and independent variable are education, and then gender, and then ethnicity. In this case, what happens? Wage is dependent upon education, okay. But Education will have interaction with gender also. That means, say for example, there is one male and one female having the same education. The ways may be different. So we call it interaction between education and gender. Or similarly, there will be interaction between education and ethnicity also. Black men and black female will receive different ways. And white male and white female will also receive different ways. So these effects are called interaction effect. You can spot interaction effect either by literature review or your own data exploration. I have provided a link where you can understand more about the interaction. This is not dealt with in R4DS book. I have just added it on my own. Then I am not going right now to many models. I think we will put it for next week. Any questions right now? Or
not from my side. Thank you so much. This was very descriptive. I have not read the chapter, but I will do it.
Definitely. I think after reading the chapter, we will have more questions. I have not incorporated the exercises in this presentation. We will complete probably after many models chapter also finished. Then exercise we will do at the same time, I mean, in one stretch.
Yeah, definitely, we can do that. Maulik, what do you use for, have you tried predictive modeling, like mentioned? Have you ever tried predictive modeling?
I have tried. In fact, I have tried a tidy models approach as well. I don't understand correct completely, but tidy models is good. Yeah.
Linear models.
Yes, I have used it even for linear. I got one book for Principles of Econometrics and I used tidy models workflow in that. But sometimes I have to break the pipe. Just like in Bayes-R approach, we have to store intermediate variable also. For example, when I want to calculate marginal effect, then I have to store one more variable and then I can use it in further analysis. But in tidy models, I don't have to do it. I get it easily using tidy models. Machine learning, I have not used resampling and all methods so far. That way, I would say I have not used machine learning approach, but the workflow of tidy models is useful in my case.
Okay. Yeah, I have not tried tidy models as of now, but I wanted to know some techniques of predictive modeling using machine learning methods. Do you have any suggestions for the books? Like you said, you were mentioning one book in the beginning.
Uses predictive modeling.
Yeah.
That book is good if you want to understand the basics.
Okay.
And then the same author, Max Kuhn, is now writing tidy applied predictive modeling also. He is probably trying to replicate the same correct data set using the tidy models workflow now.
Okay. Got it, yeah.
And tidy APM channel is also available in our Slack. If you want to join, you can also contribute to the chapters of this tidy APM book.
What is the channel called?
Let me check it. I think it is tidy APM only, but still, I want to confirm it. Yes, project-tidy_APM.
Okay, thank you.
So, there you can also contribute chapters or even you have some problem with this book. The book is under development as of now. So some of the chapters are well written and some of the chapters need some input from other also.
Okay. Thank you.
So you can, yes,